everyone. Today I'll be showing you my recipe on how to make a Victoria sponge cake. So the ingredients you will need for this recipe are 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 4 eggs, 225 grams of caster sugar, 225 grams of self-raising flour, 2 teaspoons of baking powder, 225 grams of butter, room temperature, some strawberry jam, and whipped double cream. You'll also need some 2 baking tins. One will also be okay because at the end I'll show you why it will. And any decorations you want to decorate your cake. To start off with, you will need your bowl and a mixer. So in the bowl, you have to put 225 grams of caster sugar and 225 grams of butter, room temperature, and mix. So after mixing, you should get a light pale mixture like this. Now add 4 eggs. So now take a sieve and place it on top of the light pale mixture. And in the sieve, put 225 grams of self-raising flour and 2 teaspoons of baking powder and sieve it in the mixture. So when you're done mixing the flour in the mixture, add 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract to give it a nice vanilla flavor. This is where you have to make some choices. You could either use 1 tin or 2 tins. I'll be using 1 tin. And I know, since the Victoria sponge cake has 2 lids, you might think two tins is a better option. But 1 tin is a great option too, because once the cake has cooled down, you can just cut it into half with a knife. So that's what I'll be doing, and you can decide what you want to do. So then with your tin or tins, you have to grease them using some oils and put a baking sheet. If you don't grease them, the cake will be stuck to the tin and the cake won't be able to come out. So that's why you have to grease it and put a baking sheet. After greasing your tin or tins, you have to place the mixture out like this. Now you have to bake the cake for 20 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. When the cake comes out, one way to check whether it is cooked or not is to take a toothpick or a skewer and poke it in the middle. If it comes out wet, that means you still have to cook it more. But if it comes out with no liquid out, that means it is completely cooked. So if you use 1 tin just like me, you have to wait for the cake to become room temperature. After it has become room temperature, you have to cut it into half with a knife. And when you cut the layer into half, on top of the bottom layer, you have to put some strawberry jam and double whipped cream. If you use 2 tins and ended up with 2 cakes, with one of the cake, you have to place some strawberry jam and double whipped cream. When you're done with that, you have to place the other layer on top of the cream and strawberry. So you have to also make sure that the cake is completely room temperature. Otherwise, the cream will melt. So after cutting my cake into half, this is what my bottom layer looks like. And this is what my top layer looks like. So now it is time to take out our decoration. So for my decoration, I'll be using some strawberries and some sugar powder. This is what my cake looks like after being decorated. So now my cake is done! And this is what my cake looks like. I hope you enjoyed my recipe on how to make a Victoria sponge cake. Thank you for watching. Bye!